Hi everybody, this is Katie Vandermeer, and I wanted to show you how to use NetAcad in this quick video. So first of all, I'm over here in the required materials link for our course, and what you'll see is some information on NetAcad. When you click on this, it actually takes you over to Unit 0 and explains to you what NetAcad is. It'll take you right into here. It explains to you what NetAcad is and how we can use it for our class. It's how we, first of all, it's how we can use free material. So you won't have to buy a textbook for this class, no matter what the bookstore says. We're going to use some curriculum that's built into NetAcad. It's actually Cisco's career building program. They use it for Cisco routers. They use it for security, IoT, Internet of Things technology. And they've developed and partnered with the C++ Academy, or Institute, I'm sorry, to create this program that teaches fundamentals of C++, and then actually, when I teach the advanced C++ class, I'll be using it for that as well. So it's a really nice program put together for professionals and students who are seeking to get C++ certified or just learning more about the language itself. There's a link over in here in Blackboard called the CPA C++ certification, and you can click on this and it'll launch you out to more information on the C++ Institute. It's not a requirement for this class that you get certified. It's something that you might want to do. So the first, before class starts, I will create your accounts in NetAcad. And what will happen then is if you've never used it, you'll get an email like this one here. I know this is text on the screen. It's very small, but I didn't want to clog you up with just a bunch of stuff. Read all of this. But you'll look for this email, and you have to confirm your account. If you've used NetAcad before, you'll get a welcome, you're now enrolled in the C++ class. So you may get both of them if you're new to NetAcad, I'm not quite sure. But anyway, check your student email account. If you don't have an email from NetAcad that says, welcome to NetAcad, welcome to the class, here's how you log in, then send me an email right away or send me a text message so I can check your account information, because I have to put every student's name in individually. And well, I can bulk upload them, but sometimes there's an issue with the email addresses, especially if you have a weird or complicated email address. So text message and emails you can find in the professor link on how to get a hold of me. But anyway, now what I want to show you in this video is how to use NetAcad. So over here, you're watching this video that's right here. And I'm going to go over to NetAcad, and I've logged in as a student. This is my NetAcad. It's what yours will look like when you first log in. But I'm in the I'm Learning tab right here, and that's your landing page when you log in. And you'll see, if you're successfully added to the class, the C++ class, a partnership with the CPA Institute. These are other classes that I teach using NetAcad, so you can just ignore those. But I'm going to go over here, and we're going to launch the course. Now, I've tried to cut this down as much as possible, so we only see the modules that we're going to use. We have the way that the class is set up is in chapters, just like a textbook, but you can't download like a PDF, so you have to read it online. There are some applications, and you can also use it on your phone, but if you use a computer, it's probably best for reading it. Then we have an assignments link, and then a quizzes link, and then different files that you can access as students. These labs are just all of the labs together, and I took out the grades link because all of our grades we're gonna have recorded back over here in Blackboard. But so what I'll do is I'll say go out to NetAcad and read chapter 1. So make this a little smaller, you can see how it's laid out. So you'll go over here and follow, click here, and then read the objectives, and then go through all of these, you know, hit next to go through all of these pages. Now, when you get to a quiz or an assignment that you need to do, you'll go out to NetAcad to take the quiz, and what you'll do is take a screenshot and then transport it back into Blackboard. When you get to the quiz part, I'll have very explicit instructions. It'll be easy to follow. And then when you get to the assignments or the lab part, you'll come out to NetAcad to view the lab, or I'll have the lab as part of the assignment. It'll come from NetAcad, and then you'll use it, you'll code it using Visual Studio or whatever your compiler is, which we'll talk about in another video, and then you'll go back to Blackboard to put your assignment in Blackboard. So even though we're going to use NetAcad for our textbook, our quizzes, our exams, and lab assignments, you're actually going to submit those quizzes and lab assignments in Blackboard when you get to the Assignments tab. Okay, so you'll see that later on when you move in, or if you now want to check out the Assignments tab, you'll see some examples there of how to do that. But what I wanted to show you is a couple things that are a little bit tricky at the beginning in NetAcad. So we'll just go to the Home module, and then we'll hit Start. Now, this links out to the C++ Institute, so we're going to start right at the beginning. Make sure you click here, welcome on board. You need to accept the terms and conditions. So this stuff is from the Institute. You'll see your NetAcad, and then I have added some notes in the curriculum. I can edit this. You'll see a note from Katie, and it will, you know, have some supplemental information to what you're reading with the curriculum. So like this one, you know, it says these are some places you can go for help. And then I say you can also come to me. I've been teaching for over 20 years, and I really do love teaching programming, especially C++. It's the first language I've learned along with C, and this sounds corny, but a special place in my heart. I really do like this language. So you'll hit next through here. Now the terms and conditions, I've already accepted it as a student. I've added a note, again, another note from Katie. When you click on this window, what should pop up, well, that's good that came up, so I want to get back to this. But if the window doesn't pop up, I tried it with Internet with Edge right here, this compiler. Or I'm sorry, this compiler, it's a browser, and it doesn't work with Edge. So my big surprise, I know, but I know it works with Chrome. It probably works with Firefox, but if you can't, when you click on the click to accept the terms, if it doesn't come up, then you have to change your browser. Okay, so let's see, and you can always go back if you can't get that link to come. So again, mine went away. I'm going to go back and try to click on it again. So that's one note. Don't use Edge. I know that doesn't work. Chrome works, and probably Firefox works as well, but you have to accept the terms in order for the curriculum to come up. Now, one of the other things I've seen, and it just came up too, is that the browser actually blocks the site because it doesn't know if it's secure. Because this S means HTTP secure, and if your browser doesn't know that it's a real website, it will block you. And in some cases, the browser blocks you. So when you click on that, it pops up. It says, "Oh no, not secure. Are you sure you want to go to that?" You usually see an advanced or a continue. You see that sometimes. So click on this advanced. And then say, let's go to this site, proceed to it, it's safe, I know what it is, and proceed to that site. And then what will come up are the actual terms and conditions. Now, I already accepted it as my student, So it just went up and then went away and said, thank you for completing the terms, but you'll have to actually put your name in there and like a little signature that you accept the terms and conditions. So once you do that, then you'll see that the rest of this curriculum, we have all these chapters, you'll see that it's active and you can go in there. If you see it grayed out still, you haven't accepted the proper term, you haven't accepted the terms and conditions. So make sure you do that. And you can see, I did that, I have a check mark. So now I'm able to go on to the next thing. This welcome survey, you can just click anything through that. You might have to do it in order for the curriculum to come up as well, but I don't look at any of this information. Oops, I'm so I will click that one. And then submit it if you want. I don't really know who gets that information, but I don't use it. So then we can go on to next. Okay, now what I want to show you with NetAcad is it actually links out to the C++ Institute. So as you see all these different modules here, the material, these are just links to another place. So when I want to go in and read chapter 1, for example, I'm going to go and start here. I'll send you a link out here. This is everything in chapter 1. And when you hit next, it'll say, okay, we need to go out to this place. So if you just hit next, you're not going to see anything. You're not going to learn anything. You got to click here, and then this opens the textbook, so to speak. Now it's laid out pretty nice. You can do, you can progress through it this way. You can do show chapters. I really like this. And here, you know, unit 0, unit 1, or chapter 1. We have 8. You can see there are 8 chapters, and those are going to coincide. We go back into Blackboard and look in the assignment tab. All of those chapters in the course material, they align with what we have in Blackboard. So each of these chapters are going to be aligned with the material that we're reading. So when I say, okay, let's do unit 0, you're going to read this unit 0 here, and you're going to go through the curriculum. When we go over to unit 1, it's the introduction to computer programming. Again, over here, it's the introduction to computer programming. Okay, so when you click on it, if you expand it, you'll see these are the different sections, and this one has 4 pages to it, and then when you go on, here are the 4 pages, and then when you get to 4, you're able to go on to the next section. So here's then 1.2, and then this has 6 pages to it, and then 1.3. Yeah, so you'll proceed through here. I think we can copy out of here and search through this, but it doesn't look like we can, like, highlight things like a normal textbook. We just have to use it through this platform here. But I do like the way it reads. I think you'll like it as well. As you go through things, you know, over here is this textbook part. Make sure you read through it all. You can go back and check out, say you need to find out what integers were again, and go back and read about that. Over here, a lot of times you'll see some examples, or you might see videos. You might see links to lab assignments, how to do different, you might see the bar chart or pictures of the sky. I don't know. You'll see a lot of different things over here that will help you read through this. But reading through this is very important. You always want to start with reading the chapter, and it's going to be done online. What I would do is either have a Word document up and take notes as you're reading through this. Maybe read the assignment first, and and also, or just have a piece of pen and paper on standby and write your notes, like where things are as you're going through the material. And then you'll see that that there are labs that co-sign with, that align with this information, and the labs would be our assignments that you'll see inside of NetAcad. But those will be, like, right here, I'm in the modules, your first program, here's Lab 2-1, and, 1-2, and then Lab A. So 1, 2, 6, that's the part, that's the page that it's on over here. So let's just show you that. 1, 2, and then 6. Let's go over there. See, this is called your first program. And this page says, okay, we're almost to the end. Let's build a quick program to see how it's done. And if we actually were to open this, it's a PDF file. Take a quick look at it. This would be a lab, an example of a lab that I would assign. And so the lab you'll get from NetAcad, or I'll throw the PDF in the Blackboard, but you'll also see it over here. So I think that's enough to get you started. Please do everything carefully in the first unit or two, because it really is important that you get set up properly. I look forward to this class, and I hope you like NetAcad. Hey, it's free. You can't beat that, and it is really good material. I think you'll be happy with it. Ciao.